Hi, my name is Dr. Amee Daxini. I'm a dermatologist and I practice in my clinic called Think Skin Clinic in Bangalore. I have done my MD from JJ Hospital in Mumbai, and I'm a very ardent aesthetic dermatologist because I believe in less is more. So please join me on all my videos and let me know if you have any questions, and I will be most happy to answer them. So how periods affect acne? To actually understand how it does, let's get to understand very simply about what happens during a normal cycle in a woman. Every 28 days we notice that there is bleeding, and that is called menstruation. Now what happens, this cycle, these 28 days are divided into two halves, the first half and the second. In the first half we notice that estrogen starts increasing. In the second half we notice that the progesterone starts increasing. And by the time we reach the date of our menstruation, both those hormones reduce. When the hormones reduce, both estrogen and progesterone, is when you see bleeding. During this time, the testosterone does not get affected. In a female, we still have the male hormone called testosterone. But when the estrogen and progesterone start coming down, the testosterone in comparison is more. And that's when we see the effect of testosterone in our skin. Now just let me zoom down to what happens when we have a progesterone heavy cycle. So the second half of our cycle is progesterone heavy or progesterone high. Progesterone is a wonderful hormone which actually improves the sebum or the oil secretion from our oil glands. This causes the skin to look moisturized, healthy, young, supple. It also contracts the pores and you feel really radiant and young. But if at times the sebum secretion increases, it can start blocking the pores. Sebum also is a wonderful carrier for the bacteria that cause acne. Now these bacteria start, you know, growing, start thriving in this place where there is excess oil or sebum. Now come back to the time when estrogen and progesterone reduce and testosterone is high in comparison. Testosterone also increases the oil secretion. So a progesterone phase which has increased oil then ends with the testosterone phase where the oil is more. That's when you notice acne developing. This changes from person to person is because these hormones are all genetically motivated, also mediated by the stress and the food that you eat. So you notice that you start developing acne just a week or a few days before your periods, and that's when the sebum collection is maximum. This is how you get acne in and around your period time. Now how can we control this? With this knowledge, we are now empowered to realize and, you know, actually reduce the effect of this excess sebum. So cleansing plays a very, very important role at this time. Sebum or oil does not get washed away simply by using water. You need cleansers which can actually dissolve the oil or the grease. And those are beta hydroxy acids, that is your salicylic acid. That is oil soluble. So if you have excess sebum oil secretion during this time, use a cleanser containing salicylic acid. The second thing that you need to remember at this time is to start using your sunscreen more effectively. Because if you're using a drying out face wash, there is a rebound effect which makes the brain produce more oil. So at that time, if you use a moisturizing sunscreen, it will prevent the production of excess oil and keep it at that normal level. There are many other medicated treatments that we can do for people who repeatedly keep getting acne during their periods. One of the things that we commonly do is use birth control pills. These reduce the effect of testosterone, keeping estrogen high, and that's how it prevents excess sebum production and oil secretion and then reduces acne. We also use a drug called spironolactone. This also reduces the effect of testosterone on our skin. So all these are generally given by a prescription. So always consult your dermatologist before you start any of these. Topically, of course, the drug of choice is benzoyl peroxide. Benzoyl peroxide not only helps in exfoliation or removing the excess oil and sebum, but also is an antiseptic. So starting benzoyl peroxide, retinoic acid at night, and using salicylic acid, you know, just on the spots. will really help control the acne and prevent scarring. But remember, all this should be done under the advice of a dermatologist that will give you the exact treatment for your skin type as well as for your age.